on. Here is how I've adjusted a pleating ratio and added some smocking to a non-smack garment using geometry. And by geometry, I mean that I'm not actually doing any math here. I'm just following the built-in geometry of the pattern. I do have a video that goes into the simple math required, and it is linked below. Now, I'm doing this on a pant leg, although this will work for a bunch of different applications, a dress skirt, the bottom of a shirt, whatever. And actually, I would not recommend doing this on a pant leg as your first try, since this became much more challenging than the dress skirts I've done in the past, but just an FYI. The concept, though, is the same, so I am plugging along with the video. So to get started, you'll measure your widest part of the pattern. The widest part is kind of your limiting factor here. So the widest part for me is around 12 inches. I'll need 4 of these, which brings me to around 48 inches. And luckily, my fabric is 60 inches wide. Otherwise, I would have to do 2 panels, which is fine. It's just one less thing to do. So I ripped off 1 panel of my fabric, the length of my pant legs, and then after ironing, I rolled it up on a dowel and... Yeah, Henry. I rolled it up on a dowel and sent it through my pleater. Make sure you pull off plenty of pleating thread so you have enough of it to work with later. First, I pulled out the threads from one side and tied those into groups of 2s or 3s and trim off the excess. I need to pull enough out for the side seam allowance. Now, if I was matching up a dress with a yoke, then I would need to flatten enough fabric. Henry has discovered my nose. He's going through that phase. Anyway, then I would need to flatten enough fabric so I could cut out an armhole out of it. Just look at what you are trying to block and what you are trying to match to and see what makes sense to do in your situation. And then I just adjusted my pleats to my liking and figured out where to pull up those next threads by checking with the yoke pattern and pulling up the threads around the nearest pleat that makes sense, you know, with that seam allowance or whatever situation you're dealing with. It might be another armhole if you're doing a skirt of a dress. And then I cut down to separate that pant leg and then cut the rest of the perimeter of the pant leg out. So it is possible to do a smock pant like this. I mean, obviously I'm doing a video about it, but honestly, this was my first attempt applying this process to a pant leg, and I don't think I would do it again. It's just so much easier on the skirt of a dress or bottom of a shirt, whatever, just... FYI, by all means, I'm not trying to be discouraging. You can try it if you wish. That's just my 2 cents after having done it. So from there, you can continue on with your project. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I will do my best to answer them. And as always, I appreciate y'all for watching, and I hope to catch y'all next time.